charity or bring your ticket to give to your wait staff. Tickets can be found in the bulletin or in the back of church this weekend. A portion of the proceeds from the night will be donated. Wednesday adoration will begin at 12 noon this week due to a funeral here in the church on Wednesday morning. The Sacred Heart Adult Choir began weekly rehearsals this past Wednesday. We are still welcoming new members. We meet each Wednesday at 7 p.m. here in the church. The scripture readings and responsorial psalm are in the blue gathered hymnal starting on page 1155. Today's Mass intention is for the eternal rest of Caroline Little. If you have a cell phone or pager, please make sure to silence during Mass. And at this time, we invite you to stand and remain standing as you read those gratitude. And please join in singing the opening hymn, number 861, Praise and Thanksgiving.
Thank you. thou might give her every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have treasured. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you tried. All the day I am an object of laughter, everyone mocks. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like a fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary from the end.
Thank you. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What is this life that we seek? What is this life that Jesus promises? We know the pursuit of happiness. We know all about good life as defined by society. St. Paul in the letter of Philippians chapter 1 verses from the one who possesses his gifts. A personal definition of life. He says, to me, life is Christ. To live is Christ. And to die is gain. And as disciples of Christ, we have embraced this definition of Paul. Life to me is Christ. And in that acceptance, we have signed on to become disciples, to follow after the Master, to live like Jesus. We have accepted to be called Christians. Now, in this acceptance, sometimes the presumption is that life is going to be easy just because we have signed on. After all, He is the Messiah. He makes all things possible. He is God. That is the promise. But the reality of Christian discipleship is such that sometimes that expectation does not work well with the reality of life. When it comes to the point where my understanding, my expectation of what it means to be a Christian and what it means to be loved by God does not flow with it, the challenges, the pain, the situations of life that are not pleasant to me, then we hit the crisis point. We hit the crisis point. If God is good, then why is this happening? If God really loves me, then why is this not going well for me? How can I reconcile the fact of no worries, no pain, and eternal bliss with all that I'm currently expressing? And in my work as a hospital chaplain, I see a lot of that crisis. I see a lot of that crisis. The ability to hold that tension a little bit, to hang in there through the pain, while seeking inspiration and motivation, while looking back on those good times with gratitude when things were fairly okay. Sometimes that's what it takes to catch your breath and to take another step forward in faith. And sometimes, other times, it's just not possible. And as a result, it will give up. Sometimes we'll walk away from the faith. We throw in the towel, we say, well, this is not worthy, this is not for me. And then, hopefully, eventually, we return. Jeremiah, the prophet Jeremiah in the first reading today. The opening line is so strong as he describes his relationship with God. He says, you have duped me. You have duped me, O God. And I let myself be duped by you. You sent me to these people with your word, with your message, the people who were not ready to listen. And now everybody's laughing at me. Everyone is after my life, they're persecuting me. Derision, he says. So, literally sinking into depression. Jeremiah was in a difficult place. Work of a prophet is to carry the message of God and take to the people and take the prayers and expressions of the people back to God. Just to go between, mediator between God and the people. That's what Jeremiah was told. Gave a difficult message from God, but that's what he was told to do. And didn't feel the backing and the support of God all of a sudden. And his friend. And that's the cry, that's the lament in the first scripture. That's what that happens sometimes when we feel like God is not showing up in our life. That God is not showing up for me when I need him to be there. But Jeremiah did not give up. He says, yet there is a spark within me that it's impossible for me to remain, to not give up. I cannot walk away as much as I want to, because you are too strong for me. You are overpowered me, he says. God is there for us. That spark is still there, even now, Christ. Jesus did not promise his disciples an easy life. Very clear in the Gospels. He makes it very constant, but also here in the Gospel. What he promised us is an authentic life and an eternal life. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 8, verse 20, some guy wants to follow him. He says, I want to follow you. And Jesus makes it clear. Foxes have holes. The birds have nests. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. If you choose to follow me, think hard, think twice, because it's not going to be an easy life. If you want to be homeless, come with me. There's a cost to Christian discipleship. Something we give up. But there's a passion within you that makes it easy and makes it possible for us to do what it takes. And no matter how far away God seems to be in carrying out the missions assigned to us by God, and all of us have different tasks assigned. We call it vocation, our calling, whatever aspect of life that God has called us to serve and to take care of each other and God's people. It could be in the family or in the church or in the community or in the society, whatever it means, wherever it is that God has called us to represent God's people. God gives us what it takes, empowers us, gives us that spark within that sustains us and holds us even through that tension and through that crisis. And so we pray for perseverance. We pray for endurance and patience and ability to hang in there in times of crisis. Crisis of faith. Knowing that we do not know clearly all that pertains to God. But what we know is enough. What we have is enough. And that there will be days when things don't feel so great. But in all of that, the one who has called us is constant, always is present with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, may we never grow weary of self-sacrifice and concern for the poor, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the growth of peace, may the victory of the cross enlighten minds and hearts with new respect for human life and give courage to leaders to find new ways to resolve differences, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the police, fire, and EMT workers, may all first responders be preserved from harm as they serve to keep us safe, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, that they will be healed through Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these prayers, and for all the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we come to you with our prayers, our needs, and our petitions, trusting that you will grant them for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Christ. Your word for Romans 6 made all things. When you sent us our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gave for you the holy people, and stretch out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so when the angels and all the saints will declare your glory as a one voice. taught by divine teaching, we dare to say,
thank you.
peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.